big Judy Garland overture, which was just written, not, was made up 5 minutes ago. Hi, Michael. Who's here watching the show tonight? Hey, thank you all for joining us tonight, and thank you for coming in on Wednesday night. Michael Trotman is here, our co-host and producer. Michael, are we going to have a good time tonight?
Yeah, undoubtedly, because we have a full show of mostly women. It's just Ted
and they're
and
all right
I,
here.
Ted and I are holding down the fort for the guys.
Yes.
And then we have like people in the house. There are people in the house.
And four unruly women. Skylar's here. Hi, Skylar. And Ron Hunter, I see, is out there too. And I just saw my cousin Patty down in Florida. And Rich Runge is here. I knew Rich wasn't going to miss. And Eileen Scheibner and Terry Fenningham and Ron Hunter and Maurice and Rick and Patricia and Jane Steffens over in England and UK. Yeah. Kathy Mesterman, you told me you were going to be there tonight. And you are a woman of your word. And Leslie Perkel is with us from out in Oklahoma. She's also in the show. Linda Kaplan, Bill Souter, Rhoda Rogers, Bill Tomer, Lorelei, and Laura, and Andrea, and Michael May, and Barry Reed, and Aileen O'Neill Stahl.
I feel sad for the people that have to watch this at home, because you didn't witness the genius that is Bob Egan, right? So, like, literally, it's like 8:58 or 7:58, and Bob goes, oh, I got to come up with something to play for the overture. And you just, like, pull it. I don't know where you pull it from. You pull it out of the air.
I have one wrong note in there.
I said one song, and you came up with 10.
I know.
It's amazing. You're just amazing.
Fun. Just amazing. Having fun.
Hey, there's Ronan. Ronan's checking in from
Ireland.
Ireland, yeah.
And I see Linda Keller, too. And I just saw somebody else. Michelle Mercado, who's the head of our merchandising stuff. And I see Barry Reed and John Cameron. And Jane McNeil's out there, I'm sure. And the Jekylls. So
tonight we're doing Judy Garland, obviously, right?
Catherine and Gretchen.
Yes. I'm sorry. We're doing Judy Garland tonight. And it is a little bit of a deviation from what we normally do, because we'll pick like a composer or a musical group or a musical artist who had a long career in the recording industry. Judy Garland is obviously known for her voice. But as far as a recording artist, she really didn't put out a lot of albums. She was her music came from her movies and from her concert appearances. She has a lot of live recordings, live at Carnegie Hall, live at the Palace, you know, and she had a TV show, and of course her MGM career, and then her career at Warner Brothers. But she was not somebody who spent a lot of time in the recording studio.
Yeah, like Ella and Frank.
Right,
and stuff.
Exactly. Not Ella, not Frank, not Johnny Mathis or Nat King Cole or any of the people that we've dealt with recently. But yet her voice is unmistakable. And probably if all you have to do is hear like two or three notes that she sings, you know exactly who she is.
One time Eddie Bruce and I were talking about her, because we both at the same time, this is probably like 20 years ago, we both discovered all the Judy Garland TV show that you could find on like black and white,
right.
and CBS, he said watching those shows and watching her perform was like a masterclass. Like everything was so, nothing was thrown away. Everything was so spot on. She knew every lyric. She had emotion behind everything. She was one of the most finest performers ever.
They said that she's the greatest talent that ever sang.
I really have to agree with that. And if I think back too, when I think about concerts, that if I could go back in time and magically put myself in the audience to any one of these concerts, you know, there would be, of course, Woodstock, and there'd be Frank Sinatra the Sands, or what was the other one? The Madison Square Garden,
right,
with Howard Cosell.
Yeah, that is a little old. Like, I'd much rather see him earlier
in his
career.
The Sands was really good, or any of the Rat Pack shows. Yeah. And Judy Garland at Carnegie Hall.
That was the finest concert.
Performances ever.
It was called the best night of entertainment ever on earth.
Extraordinary. When I was talking to all my people on the show tonight, they said, I said, as long as the song you're doing was live in Carnegie Hall, it can be in the show, because that was like the Judy's best of the best of the best.
But most, as I said, most of her music came from the 29 movies she did at MGM and Warner Brothers, and a couple independent films, and she only did like 9 studio albums, compilations that are out there. She's like, if you look at the list, the number of songs that she introduced in her career numbers more than 100. So when you're thinking of an artist. Who's not a studio musician, who introduced over 100 songs? That's like insane. Insane.
Isn't it insane?
Yeah.
Hi, Patty and Steve. Patty, the only
most
Steve,
of them are
James
classics.
Henry and Wally Watson. I just saw you all just get here too. What's that?
Most of them are classics.
And they are classics.
Yeah.
I mean, look at the movies like Meet Me in St. Louis, Easter Parade, right?
Easter Parade, Summer Stock.
You know, not just Wizard of Oz. There's a lot more than that. Hi, Sandy. I see. Oh, Sandy DiRadio's out there from Chicago too, and Vincent and Louisa and Chris.
And anyway, hey, Bill Pappas, I miss you too.
Hi, Bill. Good to see you. Well, so let's get our show started tonight. We want to introduce our first guest, Linda. Where are you?
A new singer. We have a new singer
because
in the house.
This is somebody I have not seen in 15 years at least, and I'm so glad that she reached out to me about wanting to be in a Judy Garland show if we ever did it, and that partially inspired me to do the show. So, please welcome Linda Benedetto.
Hey, Linda. Linda Benedetto. Hey. Hold on. I'm going to move
Michael's going to adjust your camera because we want to get all of you. All of you in the camera. There you are.
Thank you.
Linda, it's good to have you with us. You're a teacher, right?
I'm a teacher, yes. I teach English as a second language in Philadelphia School District.
A challenge.
Nice. And I have a funny story because you were mentioning how you used to watch the old TV shows, Judy Garland shows.
Yes. Uh-huh.
So when I was younger, so let's say middle school, I would go to sleep at night on a school night, and I'd have to set my alarm clock for about 3 a.m. or 4 a.m. That's the only time I could see Judy Garland films. So this first song is from the movie For Me and My Gal. And I just would do that. I would go and watch the movie and then go back to sleep and then wake up for school. So nobody knew
so
I was doing that. In
time life. Traveling back to her childhood. Linda Benedetto.
And what a perfect way to open our show.
Bells are ringing for me and my gal. The birds are singing for me and my gal. Everybody's been knowing to a wedding they're going, and for weeks they've been sewing every Susie and Sal. They're congregating. Two or three or four or more in love land for me and my gal. When you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you. When you're laughing, when you're crying, you bring on the rain, so stop your sighing. Be happy again, keep on smiling, 'cause when you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you.
Linda Benedetto! Oh, Linda, that was fantastic. You know, you're right down the street in Holland, and I have never met you before.
Yay!
I feel like this is meant to be.
I hope this is the first of many.
Yes. Remember now, if you talk, please talk directly into the mic. People are giving me a hard time. I know.
They want to hear everything.
They can't hear
the
talking. You sound fabulous, by the way.
Thank you.
You're doing a song from the film Meet Me in St. Louis.
Yeah.
My favorite musical. of Judy Garland.
She has some of the best songs in that movie. And, you know, it was such a huge hit, and it's really a musical about nothing. Like, nothing happens. Like, literally, think about it. It's like, oh, we're all happy. The fair's coming to St. Louis. Oh, we might have to move. But we're not. That's the whole movie in a nutshell.
Right.
But the best thing about it is in between that, you have all those amazing songs, right? And all these amazing seasons, and you get to see a turn of the century family, and it's really a beautiful film. It's a beautiful film.
There's so many sweet moments through all the seasons, like you said. Yes.
And this is one of my favorite songs from the movie. So once again, Linda Benedetto. It's
beautifully filmed, too. So anyway, here.
Kensington Avenue, and he lives at 5133. How can I ignore the boy next door? I love him more than I can say. Doesn't try to please me, doesn't even tease me, and he never sees me glance his way. And though I'm heart sore, the boy next door affection for me won't display. I just adore him, so I can't ignore him. The boy. Try to please me, doesn't even tease me, and he never sees me glance his way. And though I'm heart sore, the boy next door affection for me won't display. I just adore him, so
Linda Benedetto. Oh, Linda, thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank
great
you so much
songs,
for having me.
Too.
What great debut. Thank you so much.
I can't wait to have you back already.
I know, seriously. Great comments for Linda. She sounds lovely.
Yes, she does.
I think my favorite comment of the night may come from Bill Pappas. Meet Me in St. Louis may be about nothing, but The Wizard of Oz is about women fighting over a pair of shoes. It's true.
Bill, that's
it's
good.
True. It's true. That's true.
Oh, I said, let me, because I had some other people out there. I see my friend Judy Jones is out there and John Ward. It was good to hear you, have you sing with me the other night, John. Julie and Ken are with us from Doylestown. My sisters, Marianne and Eileen and Kathleen, are out there. And Jimmy from Whitehorse Village and the gang, mm-hmm. and Dan Crow. Thank you all so much for your wonderful support of the show. And I also saw Catherine's there and Gretchen and the Jekyll family and Sam and Happy Shipley. I know you're out there watching too. You never miss.
It's not often that the first appearance in a show gets where it's like phenomenal, fabulous. People really love Linda. That's great.
They all say, Linda better come back, right?
That's right. Yeah.
Look at all these great. Oh, I love the things that people write. I learn so much when I read back. Oh, Ed McLaughlin's here with us too from North Carolina. Yeah. All right. So anyway, so our next Judy Garland song is coming to us from the woman who has just one name now, not Penny Cats. It's Penny Cats. She's now Penny Cats.
Is that a feline that costs a penny?
Yeah. Right. Well, Judy did do a bunch of songs that Al Jolson did, and this is one of them.
Well, this you mentioned that concert at Carnegie Hall. This probably, I mean, some of the this is on the recording of that concert, and also when she was Judy at the Palace and Judy Home at the Palace. This song always kept coming up in her repertoire. It's a classic.
And here to sing it is Penny Cats. How can we do the show without that song, right?
Penny Cats.
That was great.
Thank you, Penny. That was great.
Thank you, Penny Cats, and thank you, Aileen, my Tito sponsor for the night. And cheers to all of you. Toast to all of you for supporting live music. And I'll just say this right now and get this over with, because this is live music. We do this every Wednesday night. We have, if you've never been here with us before, by the way, let me toast this.
Yeah, if you say cheers, you have to drink, though.
I know, you have to drink. So we do this every Wednesday night. Every Wednesday has a different theme, but the first Wednesday of every month is open format. It's variety, which will be next week. Ooh. And one of our performers who was supposed to be in the show tonight that couldn't make it is going to be able to do her number next week.
Oh, good.
Which is really exciting. And we have some great themes coming up in October, which I'll tell you about later. And thank you all for your wonderful support. Since we started the show with Venmo and PayPal and your other contributions, because there's no corporation taking care of the show. It is just each and every one of you. You're all angels. So thank you so much, because we've been able to keep it going, and we got through 2020 thanks to you. Yeah. Otherwise, I would have been playing a keyboard with a battery-operated amplifier on the street somewhere.
Yeah.
Looking for the
boardwalk in Asbury Park.
Exactly.
With a little tin can and, you know, asking for apples.
So, speaking of dear old friends, I have two of my long-time friends in the show tonight. And the first one is next, Linnell Antonelli.
Linnell Antonelli.
There you are.
I am actually really proud of Bob by not saying my old friends. Like, you know, he
we are training him.
We are. We're getting through to him. He no longer says without further ado. See, it's just.
I haven't said it yet.
Not yet. The night is young.
That's right. A really tough one.
So, Linnell, you're here for Judy Garland night.
Judy.
And you have a song.
How could we not? You know, all of these powerhouse songs and signature songs. You think when you go to sing a Judy song, oh, this is one of the signature songs. But really, there's like so many of those. Really, right, Michael?
Right, right.
This probably came on to a lot of people's screen or in their consciousness from around 1938, even though we weren't alive, when Judy was singing this to Clark Gable. But this was a very big hit that Al Jolson had internationally. Yeah, in 1913. And they had to ship like 25,000 extra pressings or something to Great Britain because it was such a tremendous hit. Now, everybody has covered this song, so we're not even going to touch on that. Everybody. And there are many different lyrics. The lyrics that Al Jolson did are kind of like, not really what Judy was singing. MGM decided to have a birthday party for Clark Gable, and they had someone rewrite the lyrics. They decided they wanted Judy to sing him happy birthday. And this was such a huge success, and these guys saw dollars, of course.
Right.
That's their genius. They were like, wow, this is so great. We're going to have her do this in a movie. So then they had her, as you probably know, sing the famous song to Clark Gable's picture, holding his picture as a fan.
Mr. Gable.
Yes, and the Broadway Broadway melody of 1938. But after that, after The Wizard of Oz, Decca released a recording, and Somewhere Over the Rainbow was A, and the B-side was this song. And these are lyrics that Judy rarely performed, but in 1951, she sang it this way, live on Bing Crosby's show.
So, Linnell Antonelli. Linnell Montanelli.
Thank you so much.
Nice, Linnell.
Thank you, Linnell. Thank you so
much. Thank you for doing that. It's another song I can't imagine not having in the show tonight.
It's a great song. You know, I think she hit on something too when she was talking about, and you were saying Al Jolson. There's no surprise that Al Jolson and Judy Garland had this sort of same song catalog. I mean, they're both very charismatic singers, right? And I think it's charisma, really, that aside from that amazing voice. But Judy Garland's range wasn't wide. It was like, it was here, and it was big, and it was belty, and it was emotional, right? Because she had so much intensity to everything she sang. And Al Jolson had a lot of intensity. He was right there.
Well, there was nothing throwaway. Judy didn't just throw anything. Everything was just had such purpose. Yeah, so another Al Jolson one that she had a big hit on was Swanee, right?
Right, right.
Swanee.
Once again, there's an aggression to it in a good way. It's not that you never lay back and sing Swanee, how I love you. You just don't do it, right? It's got to be bold.
I see Jeff Tagan and Rick are out there in Provincetown tonight watching us, and Warren Shine and Dottie Rudnick and Kim Basco and Kathy Brzezinski, my old friends from Odette's, the old Odette's, and Janet. Don Amorosi and Bonnie and Stan are there in South Jersey. And Amy Robideau is watching us tonight, too. I'm watching you, Amy. She's going to be on the show, I think, next week, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
And, you know, this next song is a singer that we were talking the night actually at Bowman's. And I was talking with our friend Kathy. And Kathy said, you know, who would really have a great voice of Judy Garland is this one, Leslie from Oklahoma. And I'm so glad she's on the show with a song that I don't always equate with Judy Garland, but is a fabulous song.
And of course, everybody's wondering, will she be in the green chair? Well, I guess stay tuned and we'll find out, because I don't even know. Oh. Please welcome Leslie Perkel.
Like the bubbles in a glass of champagne. You go to my head like a sip of sparkling burgundy brew, and I find the very mention of you like a kicker in a julep or two. The thrill of the thought that you might give a thought to my plea cast a spell over me. And I say to myself, get a hold of yourself, can't you see that this never can be? You go to my head with a smile that makes my temperature rise, like a summer with a thousand Julys. You intoxicate my soul with your eyes, and I'm certain that this heart of mine hasn't a ghost of a chance in this crazy romance. You go to my you might give a thought to my plea cast a spell over me. So I say to myself, get a hold of yourself, can't you see that this never will be? You go to my head with a smile that makes my temperature rise. You intoxicate my soul with your eyes, like a summer with a thousand Julys. And I'm certain that this heart of mine hasn't a ghost of a chance in this crazy romance. You go to my head, you go to my head, you go to my head. Thank you.
Leslie, that was beautiful.
That was great.
And I was concerned about that when we first were going to do it, because I said the way I do it has a lot of different tempo changes, and we read each other's minds, I think, Leslie. I'm so glad that you did that song, and it was just beautiful. And I really did miss the green chair, trust me.
Seriously, we joke about the green chair, but honestly, you know.
She had sent me a picture the other night of her over her friend Lance's house with two dogs, and they were all, and I said, Leslie, you realize he's got two green chairs. It's like, what's with the green chair thing? Must be big in Oklahoma.
Must be.
Green chair. Oh, Oklahoma, the green chair state. Is that what it is?
Yes, that's on the license plate, Bob. I actually love this that we have this next singer doing this next song. Specifically because, I associate this song with Lena Horne, but yeah. But this is a great song that Judy Garland also did oftentimes in her glove acts. I'm so happy to bring on our singer in the studio to do it, Miss Amy Raddatz.
Hello.
The key of she. Yes.
Oh, it's great being here. Thank you so much. You know, Bob texted me yesterday, I think sometime in the afternoon, and said, Amy, we have an opening. Can you do it? Oh, Max just pulled the microphone away from me.
I know. You were marveling before about how he like gets around the room without knocking anything over.
Be close to the microphone, Max goes pulls it out. Yeah. Anyways, Bob said, can you do it? And I said, Bob, yes. How can I say no? Of course. I'm going to be there.
And, of course, you live in the Lambertville area that was ravaged by storms. So doing this song.
We're coming back.
Yes. But so this song kind of feels appropriate.
It does. Yeah. We're talking about the weather. That's for sure. Yeah.
Amy Raddatz.
Thank you.
Don't know why there's no sun up in the sky. Stormy weather since my man and I ain't together. Keeps raining all the time. Life is bare, gloom and misery everywhere. Stormy weather since my man and I ain't together. Keeps raining all the time. The time keeps raining all the time. When he went away, the blues walked in and met me. If he stays away, old rocking chair will get me. All I do is pray the Lord above will let me walk in the sun once more. Can't go on. Everything I had is gone. Stormy weather. Can't get my poor self together. Raining all the time. The blues walked in and met me. If he stays away, old rocking chair will get me. All I do is pray the Lord above will let me walk in the sun once more. Can't go on. can't get my poor self together. Keeps raining all the time. Keeps raining all the time. Keeps raining all the time.
Amy Reddit!
Thank you.
Bill Donnelly wants to know if you were a saloon singer.
Did you know that?
Oh. Because you just, yeah, I guess they're loving the quality. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'd love to go back to that.
Ooh. Mm-hmm. Well, more see. To come.
Well, oh, back to being a saloon singer?
Yeah, exactly. Well, the ambiance is great, and, you know, of course, the liquor's good, too.
And you're fabulous. Thank you for being
and
with us,
Amy.
And
you can sing that sitting on top of a piano, too.
Thanks, Bob. Yes, I can show my little garter.
Yeah.
Thanks,
it's a family
Bob.
Show, usually. Amy Raddatz!
Usually. Thank you, Amy.
I know. I cross that line every now and then. And you can see Bob's eyes.
I get all red.
He does. He gets all red.
I get all red.
I know. Like, I love that
I'm
song.
I'm like Ed Sullivan, you know, nothing. Oh, it's not. Oh my God, off, I love that song.
I'm not off color. It's innuendo. Innuendo. Some of these songs that Judy Garland sang were saucy. There were some saucy songs. You know, she was it's so funny that, you know, tonight we've been talking all about the music. We've been talking about the things that, you know, Linnell talked a little bit about, you Made Me Love You. But what we haven't really talked about is her life, which I'm kind of glad we didn't, because, you know, that seems to be the focus. Every biopic, every time you mention her, is like, oh, poor Judy Garland, sad Judy Garland.
Yeah, they focus
all
on
the marriages
sad.
And the problems with her weight, the problems with drugs, the problems, you know, all these issues. She married gay men, you know, it's like, it was not a happy life. But the body of work was extraordinary, and I think that's the thing we want to remember and celebrate about Judy Garland.
Excuse me. Allergy season's kicking my butt.
Yeah, it is kicking your butt. I always remind you, every year this rolls around, you know?
I know.
We shut everything down for the winter.
And then everything gets better in about 3 weeks. Once the first frost comes, I'll be fine. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so without further ado.
A song that was one of Judy Garland's first hits. It was one of the first things that brought her to the attention of the studios when she sang this song. And we have the only other guy in the program to sing it.
Ted Jamison. Here you go, Ted.
Hi, Bob. Hi, Michael. And hello, everyone. The song that I'm about to do is from 1934. It was composed by James Hanley for a Broadway review called Thumbs Up. In 1938, in the film Listen, Darling, Judy Garland sang this song. Could carry a tune, never knew where to start. You came along when everything was wrong and put a song in my heart. Dear, when you smiled at me, I heard a melody. It haunted me from the start. Something inside of me started a symphony, sing with the strings of my heart. 'Twas like a breath of spring, I heard a robin sing about a nest set apart. All nature seemed to be in perfect harmony, sing with the strings of my heart. Your eyes made skies seem blue again. What else could I do again but keep repeating through and through, I love you, love you. I still recall the thrill, I guess I always will. I hope we never depart. Dear, with your lips to mine, a rhapsody divine, sing with the strings of my heart. skies seem blue again. What else could I do again but keep repeating through and through, I love you, love you. I still recall the thrill, I guess I always will. I hope we never depart. Dear, with your lips to mine, a rhapsody divine, sing with the strings of my heart.
That was fantastic.
That was really fun, Ted. I
know.
Loved it.
Last night when we were doing that, getting that ready, I was very impressed.
Yeah, that came out really good, Ted. Ted was really funny. We had done the whole song, and then Ted said, "I'm going to do it a little bit better." And he came out with a whole new take of it, and it was better.
Yeah.
And it was good the first time, Ted.
It's great. Plus, he got two outfits in there because he had the intro from the old take and the outfits from the new take. So, you know, dressed for success, buddy.
Hi, Jack Putnick. I saw that you're out there too. And Will Donnelly and Karen Clayton and also Steve Macy, friends of mine from the shore, from my Asbury Park crowd. Nice. Hey, AP. And Rhoda Rogers and Pam Fenelon, also from that area, from Allenhurst. Mm-hmm. And Chris Manella, who sings with me on Monday nights. And Rich Lentowski, also from that way. And Joanne Alberts and Dennis and Sandy and Bobby Scanlon, one of our new viewers. And Sharon Popkin. And yeah. So thank you all for tuning in every week. And every time I get to watch a show after the show's over, I watch it on YouTube. And then I see about another 100 names that I didn't even know
you
were out
there. That's true. Like you literally go, you just start going, I didn't know they were there.
If I don't say hi, it's not because I saw you and I ignored you. It's because I didn't see you.
He came over here last week when who was on the piano? Jeff Goffin was on the piano. And you're like, you have different
people.
You have
different names that come
You have different
on your
names
screen
on your screen. I'm like, no, you're just so busy playing the piano.
I know, right?
If you start playing the piano and look at the screen from now on, you can catch everybody.
Hi, Rebecca. I see Rebecca's out there, too. Oh, Rebecca and Lisa got to sing together at the Asbury the other night. It was just sheer pleasure. We had such a good night on Monday night at the Asbury Hotel in Asbury Park. Unbelievable. And what's really fun about my singers now is that they walk into a room and everyone knows them because of the show. Yeah. And they don't know why everyone knows them, but they forget that everyone watches. All these people that come watch the show, so they're not strangers when they walk in the room. So the themes, I was going to tell you about the themes coming up next week is variety. Then we have an mm-hmm. evening called Fall Songs. Songs about, you know, like September fall. And October and fall, leaves, you know. And then we have Olivia Newton-John. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Yes.
And our Halloween show and another variety show and a night of Dean Martin and a night of Andrew Lloyd Webber because we haven't done Andrew Lloyd Webber in a year and a half.
No, so you had said that. And I was like, yeah, I think it's time.
After I saw him on the...
Tony
Awards the other night, which was brilliant. What a great show. I said, I can't wait to do another Andrew Lloyd Webber show. So that is upon us.
Yay.
Well, speaking of old friends, this next guest, and I go back some years.
We didn't scare her away. She was here earlier in the year, and we didn't scare her away.
And she must have gotten the dress code tonight. She must have known what I was going to wear because we actually compliment each other.
Yeah. Well, why don't we bring her on and see? Cecily Laidman.
Cecily Laidman. Oh, we got.
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, we got. We got them in all sizes today, kids.
Watch it.
That's what I say to him too.
And that old friend thing happened as well.
He did say old. No, I didn't say old.
Yes, you did. Another old friend. It's okay.
At least he didn't say a really old friend.
Yeah, at least I'll always be older than you. And I always thought that was good when you were a little kid. Ha, I'm older than you.
It only works for siblings.
Yeah, I know it does.
What's a few years amongst friends, right?
This exactly. is another fabulous song. They're all fabulous, but this is another great song that was from a musical called St. Louis Woman, I believe.
Yeah, right. St. Louis Woman.
Yes, which was not a successful musical, but a great score. And this song, I do definitely actually think of Judy Garland when I think of this song, so I can't wait to hear you sing it. Cecily Laidman. Thank you.
love you like nobody's loved you, come rain or come shine. High as a mountain and deep as a river, come rain or come shine. I guess when you first met me, it was just one of those things. But don't ever bet me, 'cause I'm gonna be true if you'll only let me. You're gonna love me like nobody's loved me, come rain or come shine. Happy together, unhappy together, now won't that be fine? Some days may be cloudy or sunny, we're in or we're out of the money, but I love you always, I love you rain or shine.
Cecily Laidman, fantastic. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Bob. Thank you, Mike.
Thank you, Cecily.
Oh, that's awesome.
Boy, I love it. I love, look at us together like that.
I know, you really do look like belong together.
Yeah, I know.
Like you called each other.
Oh, we did. Didn't.
Oh.
No, we're, no, listen, at this stage, we just text.
That's right.
It's much that's less right. energy.
It is.
You're very modern people for old friends.
And Ray and Ned are out there too, Cess.
Hello,
that
too.
Was fantastic. Thank you so much, Cecily. Oh my gosh, people loved it too.
We're having a good time. We are having fun.
Chad Putnick said it was magnificent.
Ooh,
that's
we're
a
getting
good
lots
word.
Of good
that's
words.
That's a good word.
Spectacular
Cecily.
And magnificent. We're getting like big words tonight. Words I sometimes have to question how to spell them.
Yes.
Pam Fenlon's having a good time, and Linnell's out there watching too, and Rick McDaniel. Hey. So let's move on.
Yeah, we're going. So we're going back to meet me in St. Louis, right? I mentioned she made 29 films about MGM and then Warner Brothers. Most of the musicals, and you know those titles, whether it's the Harvey Girls or Meet Me in St. Louis, or I guess you can call A Star Is Born sort of a musical drama, right? Because she only was nominated for Academy Awards for that performance in A Star Is Born and for. Judgment at Nuremberg, which was a drama, and she was in a supporting role. She didn't win either. All those films never won an Academy Award. She was given a junior one. You know, they used to have these honorary junior Academy Awards. Shirley Temple got one. She got one. So even though she was in the film industry for all those years, I don't think she ever really got her due. And I think a lot of that had to do with her behavior issues and her... She was constantly in trouble on sets. There were several movies that she started to make that she did not complete. You know, she was supposed...
Annie Get Your Gun was one.
Yeah, Annie Get Your Gun. She was supposed to be in that. And she was supposed to be in Royal Wedding. And there were a bunch of movies that she just could not do because she had behavioral issues and health issues and addiction issues that got in the way. But you look at this musical, Meet Me in St. Louis, and she was probably in her prime, right? She looked fabulous. She was in great voice. And when she goes on the trolley and sings this song, it's probably one of the best scenes ever filmed in American musicals.
And so. Here from New Hampshire is back with us tonight to sing it. Please welcome Anne Ellithorpe.
Hi, Bob. Hi, everyone. Thanks for having me, Bob. I'm so excited to be here on Judy Garland Night, and I'm really excited to be singing one of my favorite songs from one of my favorite movies, Meet Me in St. Louis. But before I do, I wonder if you would let me just plug my YouTube channel, Anything Can Happen in the Woods. I'd love it if some of you would stop by and check it out. That would mean a lot to me. So anyway, without further ado, let's get going on Judy. You might see Percy in the background there. He's wandering. In my high starched collar and my high top shoes, with my hair piled high upon my head, I went to lose a jolly hour on the trolley and lost my heart. His bright green tie, he was quite the handsomest of men. I started to yawn, so I counted to ten, then I counted to ten again. Clang, clang, clang went the trolley, ding, ding, ding went the bell, zing, zing, zing went my heart screams, for the moment I saw him I fell. Chug, chug went the motor, bump, bump, bump went the brake, thump, thump, thump went my heart screams, when he smiled I could feel the car shake. He tipped his hat, he took a seat, he said he hoped he hadn't stepped upon my feet. He asked my name, I held my breath, I couldn't speak because he scared me half to death. Buzz, buzz, buzz went the buzzer, plop, plop, plop went the wheel, stop, stop went my heart streams, as he started to leave, I took hold of his sleeve with my hand, and as if it were planned, he stayed on with me, and it was grand just to stand with his hand holding.
I do love how she just goes at the end.
And it is such a treat making music with you all the way up there in New Hampshire. Yeah, this is why we can never stop this show, because we have all these people together from all over the country, some of which were once here and moved away, like Anne.
And Leslie.
It's kind of keeping us all together. Mm-hmm. So it we got to get through this. I always say every year we have to get through winter, because I don't like winter. I like summer. I sort of like fall, but winter is like, come on.
Oh, this is my time of year. I love this. I love waking up and going outside, and the air hits you. It's a crisp, wonderful, sunny day. I love it. Love it.
Well, you enjoy it. I miss the beach. I miss the summer. I see Linda Walsh is out there, too, and a lot of first-time people tonight watching our show. So thank you all for joining us, and like Skylar and Bobby and a bunch of other people I saw out there. I'm really glad that you're with us tonight. And I want to thank John Richardson. John Richardson started this whole virtual piano bar network, along with Jonathan Hawkins and Heather Lundstedt Price, who's in London, who is one of the partners who puts the show together. We put the show together on the night before. Heather does the behind-the-scenes work. And then we have Christian Hawkins in Oregon. Say hi, Christian.
Hey, Christian. You there, Christian?
He's out there running, making sure He is like in The Wizard of Oz. Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. He is the man behind the curtain, pressing all the buttons, making sure everything goes smooth, and he does an amazing job. So we love having you, and we love being part of this network. John Richardson also has a great show on Wednesday nights right before me. I think it's at 5 o'clock. I think it is. He does a cocktail thing with Peter Donnelly, and it's so good. I just saw Eileen Scheibner. I'm not sure I said hi to her earlier. So
it takes a lot to put the show together, as you said,
it does take a lot. And Michael Trauman, who does edits all those videos, makes sure that everybody's synced up and just right. And he you know, does all the little those things that he does that I have no idea how anyone does them.
It gets done. It gets done. But so you can see below the Venmo and PayPal numbers. So if you want to tip Bob tonight, it's all there. And thank him for a wonderful show tonight, Bob.
I call them contributions.
You're playing little fingers off today.
Hey, we love our studio audience.
Yes, we do love our studio audience.
In addition to all the performers tonight, we have Ted and Kathy with us live.
Yes, Ted and Kathy, thank you for being here.
They're the ones making all the commotion. And Andy Prescott, I'll have you know that they came too late and they missed the buffet.
Yeah.
All the shrimp that was out there. Oh, my God. So, but, you know, they brought eggs.
Farm fresh eggs. And they're always beautiful color, too.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Some people bring me Tito's. Some bring me...
protein to keep you healthy.
All kinds of
it's
good
the
stuff.
Protein to keep you healthy and the Tito's to keep you happy.
But I love the eggs, too. Trust me. They are not going to waste. So, Michael, I think there's one song y'all are saying.
Yeah.
When's this song going to come into the show? How do we not?
This is the only time that I said I'm doing a song because I figured we're just going to take it out of like the rotation so women don't fight over it. I said
gets ugly.
I'm just going to pull this song out and do it because I think we did it once at Odette's once, like on a late Monday night when somebody asked
me. I don't remember.
When
ever
someone
doing
said,
it.
Would you, well, you know, sometimes people say, would you sing this? And we go, like, sure. And we'd sing it and we never do it again. So we haven't done this before until tonight during rehearsal when I'm sitting here, you know, and Linda's like, Linda witnessed the inaugural rehearsal of this. So, but it's such a beautiful song and it's iconic and it's the Judy song, right?
I remember where I was the first time I saw the movie. I remember hiding under a table and banging my head to get out of it.
Well, let me tell you, those flying monkeys were scary. Dun, 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 dun. Okay.
So
this has become an anthem for so many people,
and oddly enough, a lot of us, probably until 10 years ago, we didn't know the verse because the verse was not in the. It was not in the movie.
Right.
And then everyone starts to rehearse the verse. And the verse is another one of those verses like Skylark that's almost as long as the song and just as beautiful as the song. So here we go.
When all the world is a hopeless jumble and the raindrops tumble all around, heaven opens a magic lane. When all the clouds darken up the skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found. From your window pane to a place behind the sun, just a step beyond the rain, somewhere over the rainbow, way up once in a lullaby. That
you dare to dream really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops and way above the chimney tops, that's where you'll find me. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why, then, oh, why can't I? Troubles melt like lemon drops and weigh upon the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me, somewhere over the rainbow. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh, why can't I? If happy little bluebirds fly beyond the rainbow, why, oh, why can't I?
It wouldn't be a Judy Garland tribute without that song. Thank you so much for taking this little journey tonight with us. We had so much fun doing it. I hope you had as much fun as we did.
What is everybody who's in the show? Can I get you over there, Amy? Amy and Cecily, can I get you on the other side to say goodnight?
And while they're coming up, I want Ron Hunter to know they all got their t-shirts and their caps and their all their...
You can come up here with me, Lenora.
Hi, Kathy Rebars. I just saw you out there. They all got their virtual piano bar paraphernalia. Linnell, thank you, and Cecily, and Linda, and Amy, and Michael. It's the good night, sweetheart. Thank you all. Love you guys. See you again real soon. Thanks for joining us tonight. It means a lot. I appreciate it. Good night.